Hello, Reviteers. Now that you saw part one of our lecture and you know how amazing BIM can be, I know you're really excited to jump in and try this on your own. Let me ask you a quick favor though. I lecture pretty quickly. Remember, you guys are going to be able to pause and rewind. So I'm going to get to the point pretty quick. What I'm going to ask you to do, especially in this first lecture, part two, that I'm about to do, please watch the entire thing. And then try it on your own. And then when you try it on your own, that's where you can like pause and rewind. I think getting a sense of the whole picture before you start it on your own will really make a big difference. So again, I promise this won't be long. It won't take too much time to just quickly watch it. You can even watch it like going 1.5 times the speed if you want to speed it up. But please watch the whole thing and then start it on your own. And then you can pause and rewind as you wish. So we're going to go ahead and start our own new project. And the best thing about starting our first new project is that we're going to be going over these fundamentals over the next 2 or 3 weeks. So we're going to do it today. We're going to do it again in our next module with a little bit more complexity. And then we're going to do it one more time with that same level of complexity. So you're going to see this over and over again, because these are the real fundamentals that I want to become intuitive to all of you. So there's a few things to think about before we get started. And that is from the very beginning, when we go to open up a new project, let's think about the type of template we want to use. So in Revit, we want to use the Imperial Architectural. So Imperial means that we're going to be using feet and inches. If we were in just about anywhere else in the world, you know, Canada, Japan, we'd be using metric, but we are using the imperial system along with England. So imperial architectural. And I just wanted to let you know that throughout the course of the semester, we will be using the architectural template as well as the residential template. For today's intro, we're going to start with the architectural. And then in our next module, we're going to jump into the residential. So after that, you can go ahead and just create a new project. You don't have to click anything there, but go ahead and click on OK. And this is the first screen that we're going to take a look at when we open up a Revit project. Quick overview, this particular lecture, we're going to do almost everything out of the box. With Revit, there's a few things that I will change, but not many. And then next week, when we start our new project, we're going to go much more in depth and do a lot more customization. The customization will include the type of walls, the height of walls, even like the type of construction. But again, this week, we're going to look at Revit pretty much out of the box. So starting off, let me take you on a tour of what we see. We're in level one, and we know we're in level one because it says it here in our view, and it also says it in our project browser. If you look at our properties, it tells you that we are in a floor plan view. So that means that we're not looking at a 3D view, and a floor plan view is, again, look in the room that you're in right now. If you were to turn your room into a floor plan, it would mean that you would get a giant saw, chop off your walls at about the 4 or 5 foot point, lift off the ceiling and get into a hovercraft and look straight down. That's the view we've got right now. So for those of you who have been like, you know, self-isolating and not on a vacation, hey man, I just popped you in a hovercraft. You're still home, but you're in a hovercraft at least. The other things that we see on the screen are these things that kind of look like little houses turned over on its side, right? These are actually our exterior elevation marker views. Think of them as little cameras that are looking into what you're about to create, translating it into these elevation views. Okay, so these are little elevation cameras. We don't want to get rid of those. They just stay there and translate our view, part of like the whole BIM modeling system. Now, I'm sorry I'm talking so much, but you know, this class is heavy lecture, so bear with me. What I'm about to build is kind of like the typical house that you might build or sketch as a kid. We're going to draw a 15 by 15 box, and I might make it 15 feet high, you know, really make it a box, and I'm going to throw on a roof. And by doing that, I'm going to show you guys how to use the wall command, the things to think about when you're drawing a wall, how to set up your views, and I'm also going to show you how to maybe even throw on a roof. We'll see how it goes. So as I mentioned in part one, I want you to see this in more than one view, because remember, this isn't like AutoCAD or drafting. We're looking at it from many different points. So in addition to level one, let's open up our north elevation as well as a 3D view. Now, you probably don't have a default 3D view here, but look at this. Here's my cursor. Come on up here with me. There's this adorable little house here. It's our 3D view. As soon as we click on that, it'll make a 3D view. It's a blank, but now you'll notice that we will also have a 3D view panel. That wasn't there just a moment ago, but now it is. Now, if you want to get some brownie points, think about this for just a minute. You know, you can give yourself a gold star or a pat on the back. How do I look at all of these views at once? What was that shortcut? Was it TV for tile views, or was it WT, window tile? Try them both. Which one was it? It was WT, window tile. And the great thing about this is that you can, so for example, this worked out perfectly. I wanted level one here. Let's say your level one didn't end up on the large side. You click in that window, hit WT, and you see how it switches them? This is the weird part. You have to click back into that window, WT. Now my 3D view's here. Click into it again, WT. So this is where I want you to be. Level one, okay, I'm gonna kind of center this so I see all four of those cameras. In the 3D view, I click into it. Now remember to scroll out, I take rollerball down, okay? And I'm just gonna rollerball up a little bit. And my north side is pretty much blank. I can't really see a lot here. Okay, here we go. I can see level one and two. So rollerball up, rollerball down, and then kind of move it around like this. It's a press and hold of your roller ball. Okay, that's what we've got going on over here. So this is a great place to get started. And remember, I'm gonna just be doing a really simple 15 by 15 by 15 little house, okay? Just like a little sketch. So up here in our architecture menu, I've got my wall icon. If you want to use the shortcut, it's WA, or just click on wall. You don't need to do the pull down, so you don't hit the triangle. You should actually hit this portion of it right here. And Revit is very helpful. It's like, oh, you want to hit that button? This is what it means. Oh, you want to hit this button? This is what it means. I do appreciate the help, but what I'm trying to show you, it's getting a little bit overbearing. But again, to do wall, it's WA. And the wonderful thing about our ribbon is that our ribbon, as well as our properties menu, changes. They're dynamic based on what we're working on, okay? So there's a lot going on right now, but in a nutshell, it's showing us that we're gonna be drawing a wall using a line. We're not doing a rectangle or a curve or any one of these shapes. We're doing a line, which is great. Now, out of the box, it's saying, what's your height? Right now we're saying it's unconnected 20 feet. What on earth does that mean? I'll tell you in just a moment. And it's also telling us that when we draw our wall, we're drawing it from the center line. So remember, you're not doing this, you're just watching. So if I start drawing a wall and I click, you can see there's this wall being drawn there. And do you see when I'm drawing, it's actually putting the cursor in the center of the wall. Now take a look at that corner. Is that gonna be easy for me to draw a 15 by 15 foot box if it's overlapping at the corners like that? Not really. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna hit escape. Do you guys remember how I get rid of something? Control Z, undo. I'm gonna undo that. That's one of my favorite things. So WA, to be honest, I feel like I'm undoing just as much as I'm doing in this program. So I said that most of it was going to be out of the box, but not all of it. Whenever we draw a wall in Revit, we want to make sure that it's associated or connected to a level. The only time that we don't associate a wall with a level is if it was a wall that was just kind of like freestanding. Like if you had a reception desk with like a wall in front of it, or you had like a booth in a restaurant and you had a wall that wasn't full height, then you could do an unconnected wall. But we want to actually connect our wall. And if you take a look here, this is level one. So if we were to start drawing a wall here, does it make sense to start and end at the same level? Hopefully you're saying no. You want your wall to have some height to it. So let's take it up to level two. So just based on my elevation, how high will that wall be? I hope you're all saying 10 feet to yourself right now. Okay, so we've taken the wall and we've associated it with level two. And the other thing that we're going to change is that instead of doing the wall center line, which is the default, I'm going to do finish face interior. So that means that when I draw my wall, it's going to show what it looks like, or the dimension of it from the interior side. Okay. And for now, those are the only two things that I am going to change. I'm going to keep it the basic generic 8-inch wall. You can see that if you click here and scroll down, there's so many different walls to choose from. But I do want the generic 8-inch. That's totally fine for now. And now I'm going to go ahead and draw that 15-by-15-foot box. So this is the part where I think it's even more helpful to watch me do it first before you start. If you've even taken CAD, I should have done the speech at the very beginning. But for all of my CAD people, CAD does not help you in Revit. In fact, it's better if you pretend you don't know it. Think about it like a family. Do you have like a sibling or a cousin? And even though you're from the same family, you're completely different from them. This could not be more true for Revit and AutoCAD. Yes, it has the same parent, but they could not be more different. So it won't help you. So this is bad news for people who are really good at CAD and they're like, oh, I was so good at CAD, I'm gonna be so good at Revit. I'm sorry, not true. But for those of you who didn't love CAD, oh, this is the best news. You might not have loved CAD, but trust me, everybody loves Revit. So what I'm gonna do, I'm finally gonna start drawing a wall. It's as simple as a click and a drag, but you need to pay attention to a couple things. So first, remember, see that little blue line, my guide? That is the inside of my wall, which is great. So if this is the inside of my wall, I'm gonna let you think about this for a minute. For my next wall, if this is the interior, would I start drawing it up or down? Okay, let me at least finish this. So I'm not gonna try to find 15 feet and click. That takes way too long. Ain't nobody got time. Type in 15, you see it coming up on my screen, enter. So Revit thinks in feet, not inches. And here's my other question. So would we go up to do the next 15 feet? We'd actually go down based on how I started. So now here I go down 15, enter. This is super easy. I come over here and do you see that it's doing all these like great things to make sure that our lines are straight? So I can type in 15, enter again, or if I keep dragging, do you see that it's giving me these they're called tracking points. It says, hey, look, I found an intersection. And this is great. That's my 15 feet. So I can click and I can drag up and then click here. And then when I'm all done drawing walls, I go ahead and hit escape and then look at my cursor. See how it's still that a target. It still thinks it's drawing walls. Even if I look at my file, yep, modify place wall. So it's going to keep drawing walls. I don't want to keep drawing walls. So I hit escape once, I hit escape twice, and I'm cleared out of walls and into my architecture menu. So really cool. Look, I did these walls and I have an elevation in like 5 minutes. These walls have thickness. I have a 3D view. Look, I did like some abstract sculptural garden. You know I didn't want this. So how do I get rid of it? Please shout at your computer. Anybody? Bueller? Anybody? Hopefully somebody said Control Z. So here's my cute little box right here. I've got a 15-foot-by-15-foot box. Now, you might be wondering, okay, I'm about to draw this, but how can I know it's 15 feet by 15 feet? Well, I wish you could just click on a wall and Revit would tell you, oh, it's 15 feet. See how this is telling me it's 15 feet, 8 inches? That's because when you do quick dimensions, it by default measures from the center of the wall to the center of the wall. But what I can do is on my quick dimension, you see this little blue dot? I can click on that and that moves the line. And I can click on this blue line and it moves it again. Now, you might have a situation where you have to click on it a few times, right? But eventually it does tell me, ah, this is 15 feet. So I can check this side too. So if I click on this wall, there's my 15.8. Click on the blue button, click on the blue button. If you happen to like the dimension and want to keep it on, see this little dimension right here? When I'm hovering, it like finishes my sentences for me. Look at this. It's like, make temporary dimension permanent. Thanks, Revit. We should be a rap duo. Sorry, guys. It's late. So there's my 15 feet. That's how I know that it worked. Now, coming over here in my elevation, in our elevation, I only have 10 feet here. Not bad, but remember when we started, I said that I wanted to draw a 15 foot by 15 foot by 15 foot box. So here is, this class should just basically be called Naima Professes Her Love for Revit. And this is only because I spent like the first part of my career drafting everything in CAD, which is, it has its benefits, right? I get why people like CAD, but man, there's stuff that's tedious. But look at how awesome this is. So take a look here. I feel like I'm about to be a magician. So this should be really simple. Where it says level 2, 10 feet, it might help to zoom in because you see there's all these boxes it wants to highlight. I really want to make sure I'm getting on the 10 feet. So I got the 10 feet, clicked on it. I'm going to click on it again. Now it's like, oh, you don't want it to be 10 feet. What do you want it to be? 15. Enter. No, take a look up here. Boom. And remember when we first started drawing those walls, we connected them to the second level. We know we did it correctly because when I moved that second level, the walls moved with it. Now, again, imagine having to do this by hand or in CAD. You'd have to go through and do each wall individually. Okay? Not very fun. And let me just show you again with both of them on the screen. So if I change this to 12 feet, it keeps moving along because it knows that wherever level 2 goes, those walls are going up from level 2. It's pretty awesome. So really simple way to quickly get some walls, a 3D view, and an elevation. I'm not done yet. Wherever you are now, again, I know that I went really quickly. So pause. Slow it down, rewind, whatever you need it. But come up here on the 3D view, and what you can do on the 3D view, if you want to see it from a different angle, hold the shift key and press down on your roller ball, and you can kind of spin or orbit around the view if you want. If you ever lose the view, any view, double click on your roller ball, and it does like a zoom all. It'll bring things back. So for example, in level 1, let's say you panned too much, you're like, oh my gosh, I lost my floor plan, it's gone forever. Nope. Double click on your roller ball, it'll come back. Okay? So that's a double click on your roller ball is a zoom all. Yeah, so exciting. Now, if you've made it to this point, congratulations. I want to do maybe two more things while we're here. Let's just show you how fancy Revit is. In the level 1 view, click on door for me. And, here's a door that we can put in. Oh, thank you. You can see it's just waiting. So if you can see that there's like a stop or a no sign, because Revit knows that doors don't go in the middle of spaces. Doors go in walls. So if I come and hover on a wall, if I hit spacebar, I can change the hinge of the door. If I take my mouse towards the top side of the wall, it opens into the house. If I take it to the outside, it opens to the outside, right? But you get a door, and you get a door, and you get a door. And then when you're done putting in doors, just like the walls, hit escape a couple times, and you're done putting in doors. Oh, sorry, door. I got rid of you. But look, I've got doors in my model now. Happy little doors. I'm like the Bob Ross of Revit. Happy little doors. Okay, want to put in a window? You can have windows. Again, we're just doing it out of the box. Out of the box, this is what we get. So I'm going to click on to level one. You get a window, and you get a window, and let's put one here so you don't feel so naked, right? I mean, they're free. We're not paying for these. We'll let the contractor and owner fight it out. Okay, next week, we're going to go over how to put these in, you know, without just, like, clicking. But I'll show you guys how to put dimension to it, how to center them. But for now, you can just kind of see what it feels like to put that stuff in. Pretty impressive, right? Like less than an hour in and check out what we're doing. The next thing I want to do while we're here is maybe throw on a roof. Let's see how that goes. So what I'm going to do is we're going to pretend level two is our roof view. So I'm going to double click on level two. And do you see that it's kind of ghosting in level one? It's definitely not as dark. So look at what level one looks like. Look at level two. Level two is just like, oh yeah, there's these walls that come up to me, right? They're like right below. And what we're going to do on level two is we're going to draw our roof. And if you look up here in the architecture menu, boom, there's a roof. And again, we're going to do pretty much everything just out of the box. So for this next part, I'm just going to click on roof, and it wants me to start sketching something, okay? Before I get started, I'm going to click on the rectangle. So see over here where I'm dancing? Click on rectangle. This is not going to be a good-looking roof, but it's going to be a roof. Again, less than an hour of riveting, and we're drawing a roof. Doesn't matter what this means. We're going to figure out what this means later. So just draw a rectangle around those walls and then hit this green check in the middle. Finish edit mode. And look, look in our 3D. Ignore that. Who cares what that looks like? People, I have a master's degree in architecture. Look at my beauty at work. Oh yeah. So, but I mean, this is your BIM model. I know this is silly, but that's kind of a lot to do in such a short amount of time, right? We've got roof, walls, windows that quickly. This is kind of your intro to BIM. And if we wanted to be really, really specific, we could take level two. Okay, so in our project browser, this is where you go really, really slow, okay? Double click on level two. Okay, so I lied, don't click on. Oh yeah, double click. Double click or right click and go to rename, either one, okay? And what I want you to do is rename this to roof, and it's going to ask you a very important question. Hit enter. It's going to say, would you like to rename the corresponding level and views? Yes, okay? And then the next time it asks you that, save it, because look, this now says roof, this now says roof, and boom. Is your mind blown? This says roof. So you can call these levels whatever you want. You could rename this, the roof is on fire. Okay, would you like to rename? Yes, the roof is on fire, the roof is on fire. You guys are way younger than me. You're like, why is she talking about the roof being on fire? It's a thing we used to say. Maybe you say it again. The 90s are back. Maybe you guys are saying it again. Oh, I miss you guys. If we were in class, three of you would laugh and the rest of you would roll your eyes. So for the three of you guys laughing at home, high five. For the rest of you, deal with it. We've got a whole semester. This is just the first night. Anyway, hey, this is your intro into Revit. What I want you guys to do is just kind of play around with this. And I'm going to have you guys send me a screenshot of your screen just like this, so that I can see, you know, a little bit of level one, probably level two, either one, but just like your 3D view setup, I wanna see how far you got. And I will add printing as one of our lectures, but we will continue printing next week because printing it's like a novel when you work in Revit. That always takes a minute, but this is just to help get us started. Again, I hope you guys had fun. First couple times, pretty crazy. If you can do this lecture a couple times, if you're feeling really motivated, see if you can model up the room that you're working in and you can send it to me for extra credit. So we'll see how that goes. Thanks, guys.